I am Leorey Saligan, and we are in the Division of Intramural Research Lab of the National Institute of Nursing Research. I'm interested in looking at what is the cause of fatigue after receiving cancer therapy. I came from the Philippines. I came here to become a bedside nurse, first in a nursing home and into the hospital setting. Personally, both my parents have cancer. They received treatment over time, even as a nurse where you're really caring for patients and family members. I can't help when my family complain of being tired after they receive cancer therapy. So it's really frustrating. And what that drove me to really pursue that interest of understanding this behavior. And so those experiences helped me to become more aware of what my patients feel and what they need. So these are driving the program that I'm interested in to pursue scientifically. Fatigue is such a common problem. Yeah. Everyone gets fatigue, but more so with people who are receiving cancer therapy. So they get really fatigued to the point that they're unable to do their daily activities. Even dressing up is hard for them to do. So it's really interesting. Currently, there's no treatment. We can't treat people who are complaining about being tired. And so I am looking at understanding why are we becoming tired, especially after receiving radiation therapy for cancer. So our lab is very exciting, very active. There's a lot of things that are going on. So we do a lot of bench work. We collect samples from our patients that visit during their treatment and even after the treatment, because we're interested to know what their fatigue experience after their treatment. So we collect blood. Once we get those blood, we process them, separate them into different components, different cells, plasma, and all those different sample types. We have some hints that these are the pathways that are involved with the fatigue experience. And we have to go towards causation. A lot of pipetting, a lot of imaging, looking at the microscope, on these cells, a lot of staining of these cells and the different proteins that we saw. This is a muscle cell, and it shows we're looking at whether the question is whether there is inflammation when you're tired, when you're fatigued. And this is an evidence that shows that in a muscle, when someone is tired, there is some signs of inflammation. I work closely with oncologists from the National Cancer Institute. I also work with basic scientists. These various individuals, physical therapists, occupational therapists, and even a psychologist and psychiatrist helped me develop and understand the real experience of fatigue. I'm hoping we will understand at least some pathways that causes fatigue, and we have really definite and optimized the intervention that can treat fatigue. That's the plan, and that's where the target is. In 15 years, we will find a cure for fatigue. This is the most amazing job in the world, not only because it is science is exciting, but because you discover things. I mean, discovering new things is just fascinating to live every day, wake up every day to know that, wow, these are new things that really advance, that impacts actual people. And it is very exciting to come to work every day to have that kind of motivation. Join those activities that your school, and they have a lot of research activities and even science fairs. Be involved with those, because those are the ones that help you think and help you get excited. Young kids and teenagers, like, you are our future. So we need you to be really involved. You are the future of science and of research.